Monday again. Just closing the gates. So last week's vlog is now live, and I need to up my vlogging skills because last week I was so busy that I got snippets of being here, there and everywhere, but I didn't really put anything in between, so it was a bit of a mashup. Bit of a mashup of basically just being behind Kokey's ears last week. So this week is a little bit more laid back. Yay! I have just got down to the yard. Nothing exciting for me today, but I thought I'd take you along anyway. Frank needs his leg washing because I'm still battling mud fever from literally last year. We get tiny little bit close to it being healed, and then he catches it. Really, I need to get a sausage boot back on him, I think. I think it's called a sausage boot. I don't know. I feel like you'll know what I mean though. So it's the little rubber circle ring that goes around the bottom of his like fetlock, and it just stops him catching himself. But he's always had one on, and then he broke it, and then I didn't replace it. So I think that's why he's actually catching himself. Also, my hay fever is playing up, so I apologise. I don't normally sound like I can sing a bit of jazz. So yeah, I'm gonna bath Kokey, I think, because it's really warm, and he's still got some crusty bits on him from yesterday's hack, so he actually gets a little bit scabby if I leave it. So I don't wanna leave it. So that's the plan. I'm gonna go down and get them. I'm gonna bring them back up, give them some haylage, sort them both out. Kokey actually only has haylage when we go out because he goes on strike in the box and he won't eat anything else, and then he's real narky. But once you've opened it, you've opened it. And although he was out a lot last week, I actually only opened it yesterday. So he's out at the weekend, and then we're out again on next Monday as well, possibly out on Wednesday. So it will get eaten, but Frank doesn't really get a look in. So we're going to give him some of that and keep them happy. What a treat, eh? Don't rub on it. This is why Frank always is attached to an equipping. He literally cannot be trusted to be tied up. He has no idea. Okay, Mohawk. So beautiful. I'm going to go with this again to wash Kokey down because it literally just smells delicious, and the fact I don't have to rinse it off is an additional bonus because he hates the hose pipe, absolutely hates it. Sometimes I feel like I apologise for having my thunder thighs out, but today is not one of those days because it is hot and my legs are covered in bites as well. So anything that touches them, they're on fire, they're literally on fire. So not sorry today. Kokey's all washed and we've got all the grimy bits off him. Just, I missed when I'd washed him off yesterday. I'm just gonna go in with a trusty scraper just to try and get the excess off him. And then he's gonna stand in the sun with his net and just dry off. The great thing about this no rinse, I'm an absolute convert, is that you don't have to get the hose pipe out. Kokey's
fine with the brush, but he's such a fidget bum, like he's a pain in the ass. So as soon as the hose pipe runs out, he just isn't interested. And he'll dance around on the spot, won't you? Yes. Like so. But only worse. Next up is Frank's leg, and we've been using this, which seems to be doing the trick if you just stop catching it. I normally use Hibby Scrub. Due to good old COVID-19, I couldn't get hold of any because I think everyone was buying it to bath in it or something similar. So, old Francine over here, a local tack shop, had some of the Tri Scrub in, which is basically very, very similar to Hibby Scrub, and it's just a softer wash. So I dilute it down, I wet his leg, dilute it down, wash it on, and it seems to do a good job of just drying it out a little bit, but not being too harsh for his skin. We was using Hilton Herbs Mud Defender, which we will pick back up. We're just having a little break in it at the minute, just because he's caught it. I mean, you can see it. This is hard. You can see it, he's just caught in its bed a little bit. With the heat and the flies, I'm just a little bit paranoid about keeping it clean at the moment, so I'm more sort of going for the cleanliness, just keeping it dry and clean rather than putting the lotion on it just until it's settled back down. And then I'll try again with the Hilton Herbs because it was working, but we've had a bit, it's always one step forward, two steps back with Frank. So Kokey has literally dried instantly. It's that warm. He's so shiny. So shiny. So now I'm just gonna give him a brush off. Just to get rid of all the water marks, really. I think when it dries and it's all scabby. Gonna shine. Ooh. So the next job is, while I've got them both down, I'm just going to trim Kokey's mane. This is now growing out. It does it every summer. This is probably as much as I'll get. But yeah, I'm just going to shorten this up a little bit. You can see. Shorten it up and level it out because it's just grown out quite a bit. Nice and trimmed. Looks a little bit more in keeping with the there's a little mohawky bit, which I'm really trying to encourage to lay down, but not having any of it. Nice tired pony. Tired, tired pony. Also giving his tail a little brush through. So that is now super silky and bushy. Beautiful. So the boys are going back out now. They've been pampered, groomed, Frank's leg's been cleaned, Kokey's had a bath. Trying to control both, it's quite hard. I'm gonna go home now and probably go in the garden because it's beautiful. And then I'll be back later to meet you and just check they're okay, really. It's thirsty work.
Train, is he?
No.
Hey, Frank.
Seemed to have come down and got involved in a bit of a groom train. Frank's putting minimal effort in. Good morning. It is Tuesday and there is no playing any ponies for me this morning, I'm afraid. I got a phone call yesterday from work and I'm having a Teams meeting today, so that's just about discussing potentially going back, when we're looking at going back, because I am still currently furloughed, and what that's going to look like. So it's a bit of an important one. So yeah, so I'm at home this morning and I probably won't get down to the horses until later on today.
The plan for tonight, fingers crossed if everything goes to plan, is that I'm going to go down and ride through to B90 dressage test. I think it's 95 and 97. And Liam's going to film them for me. And we are, if they're any good, and I remember the test. I don't even know the test, so I'm going to have to learn the tests. We're going to film them and upload them to Dressage Riders online. So I'm going to do its own separate vlog for that. So it won't feature in this one, but that is the plan tonight. I'll probably put a little bit in here if I get it done and if I'm happy with the videos.
No, we didn't do a dressage test. I can't be bothered. Kokey can't be bothered. Oops. So instead, because we are planning on going jumping on Saturday, we put a few small jumps up in the school. When I say small, the ground is so hard, so they were small. And Kokey had fun, so I got some footage, so I'll pop it in here. We also got to play with a new toy as well, which Liam bought. So I'm going to try to do like a little split screen type thing, but I don't know if it'll work. Anything done. Forecast rain. I might just stay inside. So if I don't see you tomorrow, I'm sure I'll put something in. It'll be Thursday. So it's Wednesday morning and the rain came. I was completely right. And it piddled it down overnight. Lou didn't think it was actually gonna rain. So we had a slight disagreement as to whether the horses should actually have frogs on or not, and it did. It piddled it down.
So now I am literally just going to go for a drive up and just check they're okay, make sure that everyone's where they're supposed to be. I don't know about anyone else, but I always have this anxiety in the morning that somebody's got out or somebody isn't where they're supposed to be, and they never do. Like, once in a blue moon. But I still convince myself that they've done it. So today I think that it is actually forecast to rain most of the day. Whether it does or not, I don't know. But I could do with working him somehow later on. I'm hoping that maybe it'll just be a bit drier today. A bit drier through the day. Get my words out. And then I can at least maybe just pop him on the lunch later if the ground's not too wet, so obviously we don't have an arena. So I've literally just pulled into the car park of the pub, which is situated next to the ponies. They're all still where they're supposed to be. Don't know why I get on edge.
You can probably just see some blue dots in the distance. That is them. Happy as Larry. Munching away. Anything this morning vlog wise. I've actually been doing a little bit of work, just preparing to hopefully go back. It's made me realise how much I'm actually missing doing something productive, like something that's making my brain tick. So yeah, we was down to have our saddle fitter come out. Came down for July and luckily I'm furloughed still, because she's just messaged me and said, I'm in the area, can you do now? So we're going to have our two saddles checked and fitted, make sure everything's all good in the hood there. So that'll be our plan today. That'll be our ride and our time down here spent. So we're in, ready, our saddles are out, and we're just waiting now, aren't we? Waiting to get your saddles sorted. He's like, I don't care. It's Saturday morning. I'm feeling a little bit worse for wear, because it was Blue Suede Hooves virtual hen party last night. And I drank too much gin. So we are going jumping with a hangover. I'm going to go meet Amy from Finn's Road to Recovery, and she's taking Finn, and we're hiring a local venue to put some jumps together and a course together. It's forecast to piddle it down, whether it does or not, never know. So that's going to be my Saturday.
we've been to Willow Banks today, and Kokey was fab, as you will have already seen. We will have already put the footage in, and he was just ace. Like, he just flew absolutely everything once I remembered how to ride. We went with Finn's Road Recovery. Finn's just coming out of his rehab from kissing spine, so we were about on the same level of jumping capability. And Amy just wanted to see how he went around, of course, so we budded on up and went over together. So we started at about 70, 75 centimetres, of course. Finn was going great. Kokey was also being an absolute little delight. So we ended up putting some of them up, and we ranged between sort of 75 and 90, I think, in the end. And it felt massive, I'm not going to lie. I was coming up to some of the uprights at about 90 and absolutely bobbing my pants. But that's where Amy screams and shouts at me, so she's very helpful to have as a friend. But yeah, he was very good, and I love him so much. He's a great pony. That is a wrap for this week. Tomorrow, Kokey's just going to have a quick schooling session just before Monday. Monday is really exciting because we are going out, but it's going to have its own separate vlog for that. So yeah, that's going to be it. I'm going to wrap this up now, and you'll be seeing a vlog. I'm going to say Tuesday, probably Tuesday. I think I'm going to be too tired on Monday to actually publish it, put it together and put it out. So yeah, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe.